Hey Beatle Scruffs and Beatle fans, today I will be doing the opening dialogue from A Hard Day's Night by memory, and I have proof that it's by memory. I have this nifty little mirror, see, nothing. Nothing on my desk, nothing, no script, nothing. I'm gonna go up right before Norm comes in, because I mess up his lines all the time. Pardon me for asking, but who's that little old man? What little old man? That little old man. Oh, that one, that's me grandfather. Your grandfather? Yeah, that's not your grandfather. It is, you know, but I've seen your grandfather, he lives in your house. Well, that's me other grandfather, but he's my grandfather as well. How do you reckon that one out? Well, everyone's entitled to two, and this is my other one. You know that, but what's he doing here? Well, me mother thought the trip would do him good. How's that? He's nursing a broken heart. Aw, oh, poor old thing. Hey, mister, are you nursing a broken heart? He's a nice old man, isn't he? He's very clean. Hello, grandfather.
Hello.
He can talk then, can he? Of course he can talk, he's a human being, isn't he? Well, if he's your grandfather, who knows? Ha ha ha. And we're looking after him, are we?
I look after myself.
Yeah, that's what I'm afraid of. He's got you worried then. Him? He's a villain. A king mixer, and he costs you fortune in breach of promise cases. Get on. No, straight up. Hi. Hello, Shake. Hello, Shake. You got on all right then? No. Oh? Well, we're here, and Norm will be along in a minute with the tickets. Hey, who's that little old man? That's Paul's grandfather. Oh, why? But I thought, nah, that's his other one. Well, that's all right then. Clean, though, isn't he? Oh, why, he's very clean. Here's an attempt at the Norm part. Morning, lads! Hey, Norm! Hi, Norm! Thank God you all got here. Now look, I've got a marvelous idea. Just for once, let's act like normal, ordinary, respectable citizens. Now let's try not to cause any trouble, pull any strokes, or anything that I'm going to be sorry for. Especially in that television theater, because... Are you listening to me, Lennon? You're a swine. Any George. Yeah, swine. Thanks. Hey, who's that little old man? Well, who is he? He belongs to Paul. Oh, well, Shake and me are going down for a cup of coffee. Anyone coming? We'll follow you down.
I want me coffee.
Well, you could come with Shake and me if you like. Hold on, I'm blanking. Look after him, I don't want to find you've lost him. Don't be cheeky, I'll bind him to me with promises. Very clean, isn't he? Come here, Granddad. Yeah, so, I hope I didn't just waste, like, 2 minutes of your life by doing that. Pretty proud of the Norm part, because usually I screwed up a lot more. Last night, me and my cousin Vanessa uploaded, we acted out another version of the dialogue with puppets, or whatever you'd call these things, stick puppets, whatever. These were actually on my 16th birthday cake, like, 3 years ago, I don't know. 2-3 years ago-ish, and, I used to have a George, but Vanessa lost him, and Ringo used to have his own stick, but we lost that too, so we taped him on the back of John. It's easier that way, because she only has two hands. It's really, really nonsensical, and it got a little lengthy. I wanted to upload that one to Beatle Scruffs, but because of the fact it was nonsense, it was one big blooper, basically, I thought, nah. I'll just upload it to my channel, so I'll post a link for that. Here is Shake and Norm. So I've been looking for this book around my room. I lose things all the time, and this is one of my favorite Beatle books. It's called Beatles Frequently Asked Questions, and each chapter is like, it'll be like the Beatles and other musicians, and then it'll go into like the top 10 musicians they were, acquainted with, like, let's say the Rolling Stones, Billy Preston, Badfinger, Mary Hopkin. Well, you know, the last three, I guess, could go into, like, the Beatles and Apple People or something. But, it has some pretty interesting facts. It's pretty biased. But I like it. Either way, it's good. Because when you think of fact books, like, this one's a fact book, of course, they're not usually biased. They're just, like, they tell you straightforward what happened, when, why, how, and all that. But this one, it's got an opinion, and it's pretty interesting. So if you guys know what I'm talking about, or you don't know what I'm talking about, I'll try to find it online for you, post a link there. And go look at it, because it's worth it. And they have a Beatles Frequently Asked Questions 2.0 out, too, and I really, really want that one. Two really awesome books. Not very well-known books, I won't think. They're called Yesterday and 8 Days a Week, both named after Beatles songs. This one's gorgeous inside. All the pictures, John and Astrid, right here. Let me find a really, really nice one. They have a lot of George and Patty pictures. And you have to see how they edit this. It's absolutely stunning. This is one of my favorites. Look at that. Isn't that amazing? It's a beautiful, beautiful book. And at the back it has the index. Yeah, at the back it has the index. It kind of explains the pictures just a little bit. My favorite series of pictures in here are of Astrid and Ringo dancing. And here's one of them, which was edited with the kind of like goldish film over it. And really neat effect. And here are the Ringo and Astrid dancing pictures. A lot of them are from A Hard Day's Night, the set of A Hard Day's Night, George's birthday, and actually a bunch of random people. And like other bands who kind of dress up like the Beatles fans. It's Yesterday, The Beatles Once Upon a Time by Astrid Kircher and Max Skeller. I'm horrible with names. The next book is 8 Days a Week, Inside the Beatles' Final World Tour. Nice cover picture. Ringo and George. This is in Japan. And George. Those funky sunglasses. This one's really pretty. So I feel like I should stop now. I feel like this is like illegal or something like that. They're very nice books, so check them out. I'm sure they're on Amazon and eBay and all that. Maybe even in your local bookstore, so go find them and tell me what you think. And I will see you guys next Tuesday. Have a wonderful week, and see you then. Bye!